Cast your mind back approximately 2 million years ago, when our primitive human ancestors, the early ape men, roamed the African plains in a constant quest for sustenance. While exploring a new habitat, perhaps they chanced upon a fresh-looking plant that instantly caught their eye under the scorching sun. But how did these early hominids decipher what foods would fortify them versus what would make them sick, or worse, lead to their death? Today, this task is far less daunting, with the abundance of resources available at our fingertips via the internet. More specifically, countless apps that guide us towards edible plants that are harmless rather than harmful. However, thousands of generations ago, what directed our ancestors' dietary choices? Just as a child learns by observing and mimicking others, the food choices made by our ancestors were no different. For instance, if a child sees their parents consuming a banana every day during the initial years of their life, their brains will register this and catalog bananas as a safe food option. Based on the fact that our parents never eat cutlery, modern children understand that forks and knives are tools, not food. Similarly, our ancient ancestors followed the same principle of learned behavior that we witness today. Our early human ancestors were predominantly hunters and gatherers, occupying the same geographical regions for multiple generations. New plant or animal species they encountered were assessed through a basic concept of trial and error. Tiny quantities of the new food items were consumed first. Reactions to these fresh additions to the diet determined their future inclusion or exclusion in the community's food choices. If the new food item led to severe illness or death, it was avoided in the future. If not, the food item was gradually inducted into the diet. This method of trial and error was initially deemed random, but it's actually woven into the fabric of survival skills that arose long before human existence, extending to all life forms on the planet. Over the millennia, with the evolution of languages, symbolism, mathematics, and reasoning, humans have emerged as the most advanced beings on the planet when it comes to communication across long distances. This clear communication ability, ingrained in their habits by earlier generations, equipped our ancestors with nuanced knowledge about their local ecosystems. As humans graduated from being hunter-gatherers to developing agrarian societies and standardizing their diets based on staple foods, knowledge of wild plants was gradually eroded. Even so, dietary traditions and regional standards endured, based on the types of crops cultivated in the area. Fast forward to the present day, where we have a plethora of resources keeping us informed about what we should and should not consume, regardless of our geographical location. It's essential to recognize that other than learned behaviors and lessons passed on through generations, we are mammals with an evolved sensory system. Like their great ape ancestors, early humans developed a refined sense of taste that could distinguish between sweet, salty, bitter, and acidic flavors. With their deeply ingrained instincts and sensory skills, they could navigate through new experiences and gauge whether a food was palatable or not. From brightly hued pests to vibrant fruits, sensorial inputs play a crucial role in choosing the right food. However, these cues might not always be accurate. Think of pineapples, coconuts, or chili peppers. Nonetheless, generally following these cues across the millennia has led to safe dietary decisions. It may be oversimplifying to suggest that a perpetual cycle of trial and error has led humans to survive and thrive. However, when guided by learned behavior and sensory inputs, they were able to make safe dietary choices and increase their chances of passing on their genes. And for those unfortunate early humans who consumed toxic mushrooms, their sacrifice was a lesson that would last for generations, protecting them with reasoning, social structure, and the power of communication.